Since Jupiter 3, yeah. So hi guys, it's me, Deepak. And sorry for not being able to post for past few days. I know my upload schedule is all over the place at this point, but I got busy, like I have practicals and all that stuff. So like last time I said, like I will be working on GPT-3 because I got the access and the private key. And so for the past like 10 days, I have been working on it, implement my GPT-3, use it to get smart responses and see how well it can do in a group discussion. That was my plan from the start, from the beginning. So what I did. Okay, so hi guys, it's me. And it's like 17 March and it's 9:59 a.m. And I'm currently doing this GPT-3, the code that I talked about in my last video. What I'm going to talk about is I'm right now using GPT-3 to create a simple chatbot that I can, at the end of when I'm done, I can use it in my Discord bot to get smart replies. And so here are one of my few first thoughts. So what I have done so far is basically I talked a bunch with the GPT-3 code, and I was able to like what I'm doing right now is writing a for loop, and I'm gonna like ask question to it, then I'm gonna add it to my prompt window, and then I'm gonna call a question function where I will be generating the response, and then I will be choosing the best response, and I will be adding that as well into my conversation. So in the end, I will be having a conversation like this. So this is basically very simple at this point. I'm just writing a simple script, not doing much. And I still have to do a lot of things, but yeah, this is first bit for this video for those you people.
To start with, like I cannot just go and be like, hey, let's implement this. So I started small. At first, I had this idea like, okay, why not like just get the GPT-3, write a simple Python script such that it can. I will just enter the question in the command prompt and see how well it does. And it gives me the answer. Not. I was using DaVinci. It said it's the most robust one. It will give the most accurate answer. So I thought, why not? It worked fine. I was sending a for loop and like 100 question. And okay, I thought, okay. So if I can just like, so using command prompt, I can use the GPT-3 and get smart responses. So after that, I thought, okay. So this is simple. Let's make it a bit tougher. So after a few days,
today is 20th March, and currently, I have been working on this project a bit on and off. So what I've done so far, let's see.
Okay, so this much scripts you have seen where I just add a question and then it respond, and then I add that into the prompt window as well, right? But what I'm doing at this point is I have created a Discord bot script as well. This is a simple script. I will just check for messages, and what I'm thinking of doing is the message. Whatever I get, I will add it to the chat, and it will respond to what I have said. As you know, I have already worked on a Discord bot once, and it was a pretty simple one. I had like nothing special in there. I was just using, I was just hard coding everything, all the responses for this particular thing, So I thought, yeah, this is going to be pretty easy. So I went with that. I started with this is the file that I have written so far, and you can see is import OS, import OpenAI, Discord dot environment, and so this is basically the library that I have imported. Then I have this private key for my OpenAI, which I have stored in the dot environment file, and the Discord token, Discord get, as well as this is in the dot env. I'm just loading them using OS dot get environment and loading the environment file. So this is the function, and what I'm doing is just passing the passing the string, the message that I get from this def on message. This is an async function, and I solve the problem of using global variables using this bot. So bot is basically command.bot, and I have a prefix exclamation, not necessary at this point, and this is the conversation that I have with the in the playground previously, and this is the context that I have given to the API. Simple. when I have this on message and I'm just seeing a client or user, I'm checking the message ID, and if message ID is this, then question or string or message content, prompt answer, question, response. So I will just pass this, pass the question as well as who is asking the question. At this point, this is not a question, this is just a message, a chat between friends. Previously, it was a question thing that I was working on, so I just stick with the question variable. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm just using method author ID and using the ID function, using their IDs, and that's it. Nothing else. So this is the name I'm adding, and I'm getting the response, and I'm saving the response as well in the prompt window. After that, I'm doing it right.
Yeah. My idea was to have like a group discussion with my friends. So
okay, so the project is nearly done, and now I just need to text my friends or meet them and tell them that the work is done and I need their help for to basically ask them to chat.
Guys, you wanna help me in the next project? DaVinci works with you first giving it a context. So I thought, like, why not give it a context that it is a funny, confident, and a bit sarcastic bot that is gonna help his friends, and also gonna give them a little trouble. So I gave it a few lines of it, like what your job is. Then I started a conversation. I had like three friends, Aniket, Ayush, and Surya. And I thought, okay, let's write a discussion about each of them. Like, let's give them some personalities. I did a very bad at it. If I knew how I could do this earlier, or how GPT-3, but I like with the experience that I had now. If I had that earlier, it would have been a lot easier and a bit more efficient. Also, at this point, I have expired the free usage of the token, so I cannot like go back and redo the whole thing. I give them the whole context about what is his thing. Like, he plays League of Legends a lot, sarcastic. Surya has a few quirks that I mentioned. Aniket is always like a bit scared all the time. Like, he's like Morty of our group. If you watch every call Morty, so he's always like, oh geez, how are we gonna do this, or how are we gonna do that? And so I gave him those personalities, and after that I export the code from the OpenAI, and I use that in my script. I wrote the Discord bot ID, so I have to look for the IDs of all my friends. So I have to like ask them, hey, sorry, like take something. So I will just print the message or author ID and see if this message or author ID is of like suppose this number was 54701. Whatever the number was, I will say that this is Surya, and I will get the message, convert it to string, and I will like Surya colon and the text, and I will save that in the prompt window. And the prompt window is something that I'm passing in the question function that is using the API in the back. So everything, all the smart responses that I want are handling in the back. I don't have to do like anything. I just have to supply to more than 5 people, like as a service. I talked about like how I have 3 friends. Like, I don't have only have 3 friends. I'm just saying. I have 3 friends in the project involved, and they did what I wanted, like text and see how well it responds. And okay, for some weird reason, it is a bug, but at this point, since I'm out of tokens, I'm gonna call it a feature. The issue being, even though I have said that the start sequence should be AI, like it should start with AI, colon, the response that it should get from the server side, and put it in the prompt window, and then I'm gonna send it in the Discord using our Discord bot roast. Even though that's the whole program and it should work, it was initially working like that, but when I started with the group discussion thing, it started responding like Ayush, Aniket, and Surya, but not like AI at all. It wasn't texting like AI, it was texting like other 3 friends, and for some weird reason, it even started asking questions to AI. Like, it being Ayush, Surya, or Aniket, it started questioning AI. Like, at some point, we were discussing how AI. We asked a question like, hey, will AI destroy humanity? Hey,
Actually, it did respond like AI just once, where it said, no, I won't. After that, it asked AI the question as I used that, hey, are you a bot or something? I don't remember the actual question. I also have the footage recorded on the Mac, but I'm doing the editing. And so what it does is, it asks the question and it gets stuck because AI didn't respond and it started asking questions to AI again and again as Surya, Niket and Ayush. And even though we tried to change the subject of the conversation, it didn't. After that, I anticipated and renewed it, and then I got that reply that I have exhausted the usage of my OpenAI free trial, and so I cannot like use GPT-3 at all now. So at this point, I'm just calling it a feature that my Discord bot is talking like all my friends. Not all my friends, I mean the friends that were involved in the project. Like, no, I'm not sad. But yeah, that was the project. Whatever, yeah, like follow me on Instagram, I will give my IG ID in the description. And yeah, that's it from my side. Thanks for watching this video. I hope whenever next video is about the color simulator, I have like few days off, so I'm working on color simulator and I have like made some breakthroughs, so I will be posting that probably by next week or after this. I have uploaded this video, most probably this video is probably going to be uploaded in like April, although I have been working since 16th March actually. But yeah, I will try uploading it as fast as I can. So yeah, that's it from my side. Thanks for watching. Bye.